I don't camouflage. The vegan lifestyle, as far as me being raised a vegan, vegetarian as a youth in Brooklyn, New York, you're talking about the 80s and the epicenter of the crack cocaine era. My birth father, who, you know, when my mother and him were married and got together, they were both vegans, strict vegan vegetarians, and he was also a medical doctor. But after they divorced, he succumbed to crack cocaine drug abuse. He was caught up in that. So I was raised in the midst of just one side of my family is holistic health, the other side of my family is into the streets, drugs, activities that were not as productive. My mentality as far as approach to wellness and health has always been, I've been a fighter, always had to consider myself a wellness warrior in a sense because, you know, coming up in that era as 6, 7, 8 years old, going to middle school and always fighting because you had a lunch that was different. You ate fruits and vegetables for lunch and your little snacks was kale chips, you know, that your mother dehydrated for you, or, you know, a tofu sandwich, and kids would gang up on me, just throw my stuff on the floor and stomp my food. So I was fighting every day, you know, I was able to get my fighting skills up. Hence, you know, me going to martial arts classes and learning to be a martial artist and having to defend myself and defending myself. And then after a while, they just left me alone. I feel that my story can be motivation to many other young brothers and sisters. We all have our own mutant powers, you know. We all definitely X-Men and women. Unify the Hood, Heal the Hood initiative came up out of me being raised in the street culture in New York in the early 90s. New York's gang-banging community or street tribe communities came in different waves. I've always been passionate to want to bring people together, especially brothers and sisters from the warrior community. And that's just a passion I stand with on to this day. I've been doing it for so long, and I see now that it's starting to pick up. In pop culture, you see a lot of rappers currently pushing the blue and red unity. People have known me throughout the years to really just be one that, you know, brings the colors together and try to have an ongoing dialogue of commonality that we can work together to address our many social and political blockages that we face as a people, you know, and how can we use that to empower ourselves, to empower the world. My mentality with being a wellness warrior is twofold. I feel that we should be fighters for our health and wellness. We have one body here on the planet Earth. We should keep up the great fight to make sure that we keep all negative influences and toxic approaches inside of ourselves, and we protect ourselves from all types of harm. I had to cultivate that over the years and fighting my way just to prove that I can stand on my ground and not camouflage and be who I am in the midst of everybody being the same.